Somebody say local. Greetings to all the family, friends and fans of DA Sports Vibes. We're here with a young rising star in the cricket scene, Mr. Alec Avanaz, and he's gonna give us his experience, you know, his shot so far, thus far in his career. He's gonna tell us of his experience. So, Mr. Avanaz, talk to us, tell us from, you know, where you started, and take us through.
I mean, I started playing cricket at a very young age. I think since in primary school, anyone who knew me, I used to walk with my bat and everything, even if I couldn't carry it properly, but from primary school, I used to walk with my bat. And I think my father kind of pushed me to play cricket, because to be honest, I didn't really want to play cricket, but my father kind of pushed me to play cricket, where he used to take me and he used to go on the field with me every afternoon from since I was about 7, 8, 9. So he used to take me and he used to go on the field with me. I think from there I started playing cricket. I also loved football, but then seeing that you could get injured from playing football and it could stop me from playing cricket, then I kind of cut it off. But from there it was, I wouldn't say uphill, but from there it was always improvement.
Okay.
So I started playing under 14 for Dominica, and there I started playing under 15, then to under 17 for Windward, and then under 19.
Okay, so before, let's go back down. First of all, did you get any inspiration to play? Who inspired you to play?
I think my whole family, actually, because from my great granduncle to come down on the boys' side, I think all of us are cricketers. So I think it was kind of my duty to follow the path that they set for me. I always loved cricket.
Okay, and before making the national team, you played school, your school tournaments.
Yeah, I played a lot of school cricket.
And that's where you were scouted by the national youth team. Did you attend like an academy?
The academy was until I was 15 years old when they opened it in Portsmouth. But I think we had grassroots before that.
Okay, so you made the national team before the academy?
The national under 19 and stuff, yes. I think I made the under 15 and under 17 before the academy, but when the academy opened, that's when I made the senior team.
Okay, so in before the national team, playing in the league, schooling and stuff like that, can you give us like one of your highlights of your career in school that you feel propelled you to being looked seen by the national, you know, team coach?
Well, my school days, cricket, I think was, well, mostly everything was good. That's where I really took advantage of the bowling. I mean, I wouldn't say it as such that I was better than the others, but I mean, it's always a step ahead where you could see a youngster coming through and he looks like he could take it on to the next level. So I think one of my highlights playing school cricket, I think when I scored, my highest score was 147 in school cricket. I think that's my highlight.
So you then, after school cricket, you transitioned to on the higher level in terms of under 19 at the West Indies level, or there was some other cricket you played before?
I played Windward. I played for Windward under 19 before I played for West Indies. I think I was as dominating as I was last year, but I dominated the first year of beyond my under 19 cricket, and I think that's where they really saw me as a West Indies prospect.
Okay, so in the Windwards and, you know, on the Dominican national team, what would you say would be the highlight moments you can recall, you know, you can, in memory?
Well, I just started playing for the senior team, so but I think so far I have scored 2 centuries. We have played 6 games. If I am good, we have played 6 games and I have gotten 3 half centuries and 2 centuries. I think my first century was directly after the World Cup when I came back, and I was red hot and I just went in and cashed in, got 100, and that was one of my highlights. But I think going forward, there will be a lot more.
looking forward to that. And so now from there that propelled you now to being a prospect for the West Indies. Tell us about that.
Well,
the experience.
I mean, the experience, I haven't really played for West Indies yet, I would say. I played under 19 where I did fairly well. I played, I got a chance to go in the T20, the Canada League. I didn't really play any games there, but I think the experience, just being around the guys and around the international players, trying to grasp as much information as you can, I think the experience was good.
Okay, and just to the young players out there who are aspiring, what would you tell them in terms of what got you to that level? They always have the edge, what you do?
Well, believe it or not, after school, when I finished high school, I took a year off and dedicated my life to cricket. I went down to Portsmouth where I trained with Sam Kernan, that's my coach from England. I trained with him every day at 6 o'clock and after Maria too. From after Maria, I think we trained every day at 6 o'clock despite the conditions of the field. We trained every day for 2 years before the World Cup. So I think right about now is just, despite what's going on around us, it's just put your head down and do your work. I think it's no secret that you have to do the work. Things are not given to you these days. So I think it's just to do your work and the excuses, I think we have to cut it out.
Okay, and in terms of the professional club, have you participated played with any professional club?
In Dominica?
No, Dominica, but in the...
Like the Caribbean?
No, I haven't been to... I haven't played CPL or if it's that you guys are talking. I haven't played CPL, but I think in the future that I really want to play CPL. But right about now, we're just focusing on the longer version of the game and trying to bring West Indies back to where it was.
Okay, so just... You know, just to in the all your career from where you started to now, just give us a little moment that really stood out to you that you can, you know, just give the fans them a little, you know, a little moment that you can always remember, you'll never forget.
Well, the under 19 World Cup, okay. Where I scored the most runs. I think the centuries are good, but against South Africa, where I scored my first half century. In the World Cup where I scored 76 and the team was in a bit of trouble. I think that stood out for me, that in front of everybody where I think even the Indians, the team were in the stands and were cheering on. So that's one of the moments from my short career that I will always remember.
Okay, but can you tell us how, like for that day, that moment, or give us a little, let us paint it for us, like how you felt that moment coming to the game. And you know, what was happening in that, being in that zone, how it felt and everything.
Scoring that 50.
Yes. Well, before the game, I think we never really knew that you are ready for the level until you perform at the level. And coming into the game, I saw in all the quick wickets that fell, I was a bit nervous. To be honest, I was a bit terrified too because we're on the world stage and everybody watching on TV. So I think before the game that I felt a little scared, man, going against a big team against South Africa. But then as soon as the opportunity presented itself, then I grabbed it. And that was one of the things that stood out for me. Even me surprising myself that I went out there and played as tough as and stayed out there.
Okay, seeing that you were nervous, at what point, what happened that shook that nervousness out of you that say, yes, I can do it?
I mean, when I started batting, and I saw how well I was playing the bowling then. I think that's what made me get confidence in myself.
DA Sports Vibes, we're still here with young Alec Avanas, Dominica cricket prodigy, and at the Botanical Gardens, right by the pitch. And what we would like to just leave us with is, and the youngsters out there, is what, amidst all the distraction, because that's always the excuse right now, it's clear. There's a lot of distractions, you know, smartphone girls and nice things. How do you stay focused and how do you, keep that work ethic up to keep you on the rise?
Well, I think it's based on your personality too as well. So if you really want it. For me, I really want my future to be bright. And right about now, the distractions is what that will keep me from getting where I want to be. So I think it's just about wanting it. And to be honest, I want it more than anything. It's better to be stable in the future than to be stable no one and don't have anything in the future. So I think right about now, that's where my mind is set.
Okay, young Alec Avanaz, it's been a pleasure. We thank you for taking your time out of your busy schedule to be with us, take an interview with us, and share your knowledge and experience with our fans and families and friends. Give thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Yes, sir.